Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to our English class. So, in this video, we are going to deal with the last part of the story, A Shipwrecked Sailor. So, listen carefully. 2 or 3 hours, I calculated. It seemed an extraordinarily long time to be alone at sea, but I tried to resign myself to it. I had no food or water, and by 3 in the afternoon I would surely have a searing thirst. The sun burned my head and my skin, which was dry and hardened by salt. Since I had lost my cap, I splashed water on my head and I just sat on the side of the raft, waiting to be rescued. It was only then that I felt the pain in my right knee. The thick blue drill fabric of my trouser leg was wet, so I had a hard time rolling it up. But when I did, I was startled. I saw a deep half-moon shaped wound on the lower part of my knee. I didn't know if I had gashed it on the side of the ship or if it had happened when I hit the water, for I didn't notice it was until I was seated in the life raft. Though the wound burned a little, it had stopped bleeding and was completely dry because of the salt water, I imagine. So, Velasco was alone at sea. He had no food or water and he was also very thirsty. The sun burned his head and skin, which was dry and hardened by salt. Velasco had lost his cap, so he splashed water on his head. He sat on the side of the raft, waiting someone to come for rescue. At that time, Velasco felt a pain in his right knee. His trouser was thick and wet, so it was difficult for him to roll it up. But he was shocked. He saw a deep half-moon shaped wound on the lower part of his knee. Velasco didn't notice this until he was seated in the life raft. The bleeding of the wound had stopped and was completely dry because of the salt water. So let's see the difficult words and their meanings here. Extraordinarily means very unusually. Resign. Here resign means accept the bad reality. Searing means extreme. Drill fabric means heavy and thick cotton fabric. Startled means shocked. Gashed means make a long deep cut. Now we will see the last paragraph of this story. Uncertain as to what to do, I decided to make an inventory of my belongings. I wanted to figure out what I could count on in my solitude at sea. First of all, I could rely on my watch, which kept perfect time and which I couldn't stop glancing at every 2 or 3 minutes. In addition, I had my gold ring, which I had bought in Cartagena the year before, and a chain with the medal of the Virgin of Carmen on it, also purchased in Cartagena from another sailor for 35 pesos. In my pockets, I had nothing but the keys to my locker on the small ship and the 3 business cards I had been given at a store in Mobile one day in January when I had gone out shopping. Since I had nothing to do, I read the cards over and over to distract myself until I was rescued. So Velasco decided to search his belongings. Since Velasco was alone at sea, he looked at his watch every 2 to 3 minutes. He also had his gold ring, which he had bought from Cartagena. He also had a chain with the medal of the Virgin of Carmen on it. He purchased it from Cartagena from another sailor for 35 pesos. In his pockets, he had only the keys of his locker on the small ship and 3 business cards. Since he had nothing to do, he read the comments over and over to distract himself until he was rescued. So, inventory means a complete list of items. Belongings means personal things. Figure out means find and understand. Count on means depend on. Solitude means loneliness. Rely means depend. Glancing means looking. Virgin of Carmel means patroness and protector of seamen. Pesos means monetary unit of many Latin American countries and of Philippines. Mobile means a port city in Alabama, the USA. Distract means divert attention from something. Now, we will do the activity which is given in page number 56 of your textbook. Look at some of the words used in the story. Unexpectedly, disappeared, indefinitely, reassuring. It can be seen that the suffixes ly, ed and ing are used after the root word. You can also see that some elements are added before the root words. So, suffixes means words that are used at the end of the root word like ly, ed, ing. Un, dis, in and re respectively are added before the root word. These are examples of prefixes in English. So, suffixes means the words that are used at the end of the root word, and prefix means the words that are used before the root word. Now, fill in the following table with prefixed words identified from the story or with such words from a dictionary. So, you have to find the prefixes starting with un, dis, in, re that is given in the story, and also you can make use of the dictionary. The prefix starting with the words starting with the prefix un is unfortunate, unhappy, unlucky, untrue. The words starting with the prefix dis is disclose, dislike, disagree, discharge. In, inappropriate, indecent, invisible, injustice. Re, retry, reappear, regain, reuse. So students, I hope you all have enjoyed today's class. So we will see in the next class. So thank you students. Stay home, stay safe.